We understand President Goodluck Jonathan, John Mahama and Macky Sall's mediated talks on Wednesday did not do much to convince Colonel Isaac Zida too soon, though that was a promise he made to the African Union when they issued the ultimatum. While the rest of Africa watches on the turnout of event, Ambassador Adegboyega Ario spoke to my colleague Amarachi Obani on expectations of the meeting and the likely outcome.
Tell us what you think about what's going on in Burkina Faso.
The situation in Burkina Faso is pretty much exactly what we have. Many of the African countries who have democracy is not allowed to play out who it should be. The people are tired of seeing that the president or government that is not in business. And if you point out that the people of Africa are asking for a new democratic state, not a meritocracy. We are people, young God, they seize the control of the society and the country, and they do whatever they like among themselves. And unfortunately, in Burkina Faso, the opposition and the crowd, the populace, teamed up in order to peace out campaign. Adrien Kampore, who has been there for 27 years. And in all honesty, this could happen to any president in Africa that is not delivering. And that could create a lot of problems for many African countries. As to the EU suggestion of AMBA, this is not going to work because you can force them to agree on having a civil administration. But without civil administration deliver, I'm not saying the military should stay perpetually, but there must be credible selection of who is going to lead Burkina Faso, not just because one democracy, one civilian, perfect. But a civilian government, even not worse than the military people, who have their dictatorship of all forms in many African countries. So my view is that there should be a genuine overhauling of the whole system of governance in Burkina Faso in order to actually have any party politics that will integrate the idea of participatory relationship with the governance of that country so that people can be happy and have peace and also be able to look at the development and economic program progress of that.
Ambassador, but President Goodluck Jonathan and the presidents of Ghana, John Mahama, and the Senegalese president, Macky Sall, what do you think they will achieve? You think they'd be able to convince Lieutenant Colonel Zida to eventually hand over much sooner than the AU's ultimatum?
I don't think that will happen. Unfortunately, virtually all the presidents that are there, and even that they are putting pressure, they don't have force to project, to compare Zida to listen to them. They can only talk of this of moral authority, and I don't know whether that moral authority is sufficiently there either. And because Zida and the people of Burkina Faso, what they are asking for, they are looking for a responsible civilian administration that will be able to take them out of the woods. Burkina Faso has a per capita income of about $22 billion, and they have a population of about 18 million. But that is not reflected in the lives of the people. And these people are looking for the possibility of having to fight their life all over again in order to be able to have a government that will give them peace, that will lead to economic development, not just the plutocracy that you have in Burkina Faso under Kampore, that has looted with his colleagues the resources of that country, and even the people of Burkina Faso poor. And I'd like to know, this is a picture of what is going on in many African countries. So I really don't think the presence of the ECOWAS or the presence of the three presidents, the president from Nigeria, Ghana, and Senegal, compel the leader to listen to the mandate of the administration, which is the act of which was forced on him in order to save Burkina Faso from degenerating to a state of chaos. And because when you have mobocracy, you have a problem. And we just hope that that play will be caught. I will stop shortly, but I don't know whether you, because you ask yourself, when you give an ultimatum, what do you have to back it up? You are going to impose sanctions. You are going to back, for Burkina Faso is a landlocked country. So you can say, you are going to have air force, no plane landing, no plane going out. They are not going to supply anything to them. But these are people already down.
Still ahead on the program, Kaltum Kano is not afraid to run for the highest office in Tunisia. Stay with us.